अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई डिस्कस अबाउट द फिजियोलॉजिकल फंक्शंस ऑफ द थायराइड हार्मोन। द थायराइड हार्मोन्स आर सिक्रेटेड बाय द थायराइड ग्लैंड व्हिच इज द लार्जेस्ट एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड। द थायराइड हार्मोन्स आर द T3 एंड T4। T3 इज कॉल्ड द ट्राईआयोडोथायरोनिन व्हिच इज 10%, व्हाइल द T4 इज द tetraiodothyronine, which is 90%. So these thyroid hormones play a key role in the body, mostly in the metabolism of the body. Before going to the physiological functions of the thyroid hormone, I am telling you how thyroid hormone attack in the cell. Thyroid hormones are entered into the cell through the thyroid hormone receptors. The receptors of the thyroid hormones are present inside the cell. In this way, T3, the triiodothyronine, comes into the cell easily, and then it enters into the nucleus. Then it goes into the nucleus. In the nucleus, it attaches with the DNA on the thyroid hormone receptors, which are present on the DNA molecule. The point here to note is that only T3 can easily enter into the cell and into the nucleus, but T4 directly cannot attack the nucleus. T4 enters into the nucleus, it should be converted into the T3 by the enzyme. This conversion is carried out by the enzyme iodonase enzyme, which catalyzes this reaction. And in this reaction, the iodine is removed out, producing the T3, which directly enters into the cytosol, and from where it enters into the nucleus on the DNA molecule on its receptors. So T3 comes attached on the thyroid hormone receptors and activate thyroid response element. In this way, the T3 activate the thyroid response element, which convert the DNA molecule into the messenger RNA, and from messenger RNA specific proteins are formed, and these proteins are released out from the nucleus into the cytosol. These proteins may be structural proteins, or they may be transport proteins, depending upon the genes. In this way, first primary effect of the thyroid hormone is the genomic effect, as it changes the genes. And the thyroid response element produces messenger RNA from the DNA molecule by the process of transcription, and then the messenger RNA produces the proteins, specific protein, depending upon the genes. Gene changes is carried out by the thyroid hormone, and then specific protein is produced. The primary effect of the thyroid hormone is genomic, as it changes the gene and forms the genes, and from the genes there is the formation of the proteins. Besides, this hormone affects almost every other cell and organ, every function of the body. First of all, the effect of the thyroid hormone on the cell, the cellular effect of the thyroid hormone. The thyroid hormone increases the metabolism, and as we know, the mostly metabolism of metabolic functions are carried out in the mitochondria. So if we want to increase the metabolism, we should have to increase the number of mitochondria. For this, the thyroid hormone has a key role in it, that is in increasing the mitochondrial number. In the influence of the thyroid hormone, the number of mitochondria begin to increase. In this way, increases the ATP production, and then ultimately the metabolism of the cell increases. As this ATP is used up by the sodium potassium pump, which are present on the cell membrane. Here you can see these represent the sodium potassium pump. These represent the mitochondria. This pump, when the excessive ATP production occurs, this pump activity increases as these pumps use ATP and enhance the ATPase activity. Then they transport in or out the ions. So the ions exchange activity increases. This ATPase pump maximally transport or exchange the ions and enhances the metabolic activity. So in the cellular level, mitochondria number increases, thus production of the ATP increases and the ATPase activity of the sodium potassium pump increases. All these increase the metabolism in the cell. Now moving forward, how this metabolism of the cell is increases. First take the example of the carbohydrates. The glycolysis process that use the glucose molecules. Glycolysis of the carbs occur in the cytosol, and then the cycle, TCA cycle, which occurs in the mitochondria, produces the ATP. Then glucose begin to utilize under the influence of the thyroid hormone. Utilization of the glucose by the glycolysis process starts. Thyroid also starts the glycogenolysis, that is the breakdown of the glycogen to prevent the hypoglycemia. The glucose utilization increases, then there may be the shortage of the glucose. So to overcome the deficiency of the glucose, the glycogenolysis also start out by the action of the influence of the thyroid hormone. So the thyroid hormone also increases the glycolysis, that is breakdown of the glucose utilization, and glycogenolysis, breakdown of the glycogen. Then moving towards the fat metabolisms. Here the fat metabolism is also activated. When it occurs, then lipolysis also starts out. In it, the fatty acids are released out. These fatty acids are converted into the acetyl-CoA, which then provide the energy in the form of ATP. So here is also the production of ATP, which ultimately increase the metabolism of the cell. Thyroid hormone has effect on the GIT, as from where we get we take the carbohydrates. Under the influence of the thyroid, GIT increases the reabsorption of the glucose to match up the demand of the glucose. As the reabsorption of the glucose increases in the GIT, it shows the mobility of the GIT increases, and the action of the digestive enzymes in the GIT also enhances their function. So in this way, you can note how thyroid affect the cell, core metabolism, GIT, and thus increase the appetite. The thyroid hormone effect on the proteins. There is the anabolism of the proteins. Thyroid hormone shows the genomic effect on the proteins to produce the specific proteins. The blood flow also increases in the cell. Here you can see the effect of thyroid hormone on the cardiovascular system. The increase in the metabolism increase the vasodilator form, which increase the blood flow, because due to the increased demand of the oxygen. To fulfill the oxygen supply, there should be the increase in the blood flow. So if the blood flow increases, the cardiac output increases. With increase in the cardiac output, the heart rate increases. And then if heart rate increases, then the heart stimulation increases. So in this way, ultimately the metabolism of the cell increases. In this way, you can note how thyroid hormone affect the cell and the carbohydrate, fat, protein metabolism with the influence on the GIT and cardiovascular system. Thank you very much.